Hello friends, welcome to my channel The Truth of Physics. Today I will discuss the perpendicular axis theorem of moment of inertia. So in this video I will discuss the statement of this theorem and how it can be proven. So please watch the video till the end. This will not be a large video, this will be a short video. So let's start it. This theorem states that the moment of inertia of a plane lamina about an axis perpendicular to it is equal to the sum of the all moments of inertia of the plane lamina about the two perpendicular axes, the intersecting point of which is same with the perpendicular axis. Let us consider this is the plane lamina and this is the two axes, x axis and this is the y axis. Suppose here at point P, we have a point mass m1. Now we will find the moment of inertia of the mass m1 about Ox. We know the moment of inertia of m1 will be the mass m1 into the distance of it from the axis of rotation, that is O, from Ox. And here the distance is suppose y1. As this is the y axis, so this distance we are assuming y1. So here this will be y1 square. So this will be the moment of inertia of m1 about Ox. So the moment of inertia of the lamina about Ox will be Ix equal to summation over I equals to 1 to n a1 y1 square. Here we are considering all the masses like m1 over the whole lamina. So this will equal to all the moment of inertia, the summation of all the moment of inertia. Similarly, the moment of inertia of the lamina about Oy will be equal to Iy equals to summation over I equals to 1 to n a1 x1 square, as here the distance is from the axis Oy, and you can simply understand that this will be x1. So this will equal to m1 x1 square plus m2 x2 square plus dot dot dot. So the moment of inertia of the lamina about an axis perpendicular through O will be equal to we are considering the axis this, the pen. So this is the axis perpendicular to the lamina. So we have to calculate the moment of inertia about this axis. So the moment of inertia of the lamina about an axis perpendicular through O, here the distance of the particle at point P from the axis of rotation will be, you can simply see that the distance is this, and we are denoting this distance by R1. So for the whole lamina, the moment of inertia will be equal to m1 R1 square for this, plus m2 r2 square for some another particle, and plus dot dot dot. So from this figure you can see that r1 square, the distance this, will be equal to x1 square this plus y1 square this, as the angle here is 90 degrees. So R1 square will be X1 square plus Y1 square. So if we split this, and rearrange this by x terms and y terms. So you can see that this total term will be equal to summation over I equals to 1 to n m1 x1 square, and this term so from previous equations we can write this ix and this iy. So from here we can say that the moment of inertia of an axis perpendicular to the lamina is equal to the sum of the moment of inertia of the lamina about the axis perpendicular to each other, that is x axis and y axis, that is ix and iy. So from here we can see that the perpendicular axis theorem is proved. So I think that I have cleared the topic very easily. So if you really like this video, so please like, share, subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for the latest notifications of my videos. Thank you for watching.